My dear brothers and sisters, we are invite you and we greet you for the devotion. Today, for the devotion, the word is taken from the Bible, 2 Corinthians 3:17. There, now, the Lord is the Spirit. And where is the Spirit of the Lord, there is the liberty. What is the meaning for the liberty? Liberty is the meaning for the freedom. Freedom. What is the meaning of freedom? Freedom means the Lord is going to give the freedom for you. The Lord is going to give the freedom from all the things. Freedom means deliverance. The Lord is going to give the deliverance for you now. Because the Lord wanted the deliverance from the fear. Now so many people are having the fear in their heart. The Lord is going to, today the Lord is saying that I will give the deliverance from the fear of everybody. Whomever watching this devotion, that the Lord is saying that I will take out all the fear from their heart, the Lord is saying. And not only the fear, the Lord is taking, I will take all the, I will give the deliverance from all the sickness. Sickness, I will give the deliverance from the sickness, the Lord is saying. Not only sickness, and the, now everybody, they are so much worried about the finance. The Lord is saying that I will give them liberty, I will give the freedom, I will give the deliverance from the finance also, the Lord is saying. My dear brothers and sisters, we may think that how that when the Spirit comes, how that the fear it will go away, how that deliverance takes place, how the deliverance from the fear it goes away, how that the darkness goes away from us, the darkness is goes away from us, and the light of the Jesus will fall on us. Because the Bible says, according to 1 Corinthians 3:16, the God says, we are the temple of Holy Ghost. We are the temple of Holy Ghost. So there we are, the Holy Ghost comes in our life. The liberty comes in our life. The Holy Spirit comes in our life. Then everything will be liberty in our life. Everything will be freedom. We will freedom in our life. Everything we will get it freedom in our life. That's what the Lord is saying. My dear brothers and sisters, when we see Luke 1:41 and 42, when we see how that the Holy Spirit, when it comes, how it is going to be joy in that. And Elizabeth, the Mary is reaching the home of Elizabeth. She is greeting the Elizabeth. As soon as Mary greeting the Elizabeth, in the womb of the child started to joy. Then they started to move from here and there. Then the 42, Luke 1:42, when he see the Elizabeth filled with the joy, filled with the Holy Spirit, and he see completely, he's shouting like anything, because she is a old lady. She conceived the child. That is the John Baptist. That after the birth, John Baptist. The Lord first is preparing. The plan of God is very different. The Lord is preparing first John Baptist to baptize that the Lord Jesus. And same way, then the afterwards, the when the womb of the child only will be happy, because the Holy Spirit descend upon the child. The same way, when the even the after the birth of the Jesus, even he needed the Holy Spirit. He came to them according to Matthew 4:16, according to Mark 1:10, and Luke 3:21 and 22, when he see the Lord is going to take the baptism. The Jesus is going to the baptism. The John Baptist is giving the baptism for him. But as soon as he emerged in the water and he baptized and he come out from the water, the heaven was open. The Holy Spirit fall on him just like a dove. The Holy Spirit is falling. That's what after filling with the Holy Spirit, that he is doing the miracle and wonders throughout the world, throughout the life. This when we see at 10:38, when we see that the Bible says the Jesus of Nazareth filled with the Holy Spirit and the mighty power, so that he can do the good thing and he can deliver from and he will heal the people from the oppressed people and the depressed people and the poor devil possessed people. He deliver everybody. Because of the Holy Spirit, he can do like that. And not this, because of the fear, because the Holy Spirit comes, what all are the things? That the people will be healed, and the people will be, that the worry will be goes away, and the sorrow will be changes into joy. When the Holy Spirit comes in our us, the joy, the sorrow will changes into joy. These all are the mighty, mighty thing the God is doing with us. Same way, when we go for them, how the devil is run away. Suppose when we go to them, when we see the Mark 5 and 2, when the Lord is coming on the way, that time one came down from the boat. That time he is looking one man. He is coming from the graveyard. Graveyard he is coming. And he is possessed. And then the Lord, according to 5:8, the Lord is thinking in his mind only. The devil run away from his heart. Then that's what the 7, the man, Mark 5:7, the man who possessed devil, he fell on the feet of the Lord. He is saying that, the mighty man of God, the Son of God, what we have done for you? Why you came? Why you are driving out from us? Like that, the devil is saying, because Lord, in his mind only one word he said. So therefore, because of the Holy Spirit, when the Holy Spirit descend upon us, so completely that we are getting the deliverance from the devil also. Not only like that, then when we go for the, when we go further from the Bible, when we go the same way, that Samson, we know about Samson, because he's Samson, Judges 16:28-30, when we see, because he has done the adultery. The Samson has done the adultery, but the God, that's what God has given the punishment. He has given the Philistine hand, that God has given. So that time they removed both the eyes, so therefore what we have to do, like that he was thinking, that the last moment, Lord, you remember me, Lord, you remember me, because he tied with a chain and with the both the wall, and both the eyes were picked out from the body, and then he could not see, and then he's touching the both the side pillar, he's touching and he's coming. Then afterwards, because they want to criticize him and they want to ridicule him, they want to make fun of him, that's what he brought him in the temple, big temple, more than 5,000 people gathered in that place. But that time he is asking, Lord, just remember me, Lord, one more time you remember me, because these people has done that, they have done the bad thing for me, I want to take the revenge for them, remember me, Lord. Like that he said. At once when he started to pray, at once the power, it came in. When he got the power, he pulled the wall, all the full building collapsed. Because that time also, because our Lord will, our Lord is a merciful, because he will not like the sin, but he likes the sinner. Because even though he is a sinner, but he asked, Lord, you remember me. He remembered him, and he listened him, and he will answer him. Same way, my dear brothers and sisters, today, nowadays also, we might have done sin against the Lord. But when we humble ourselves, when we turn from the sin, and when we call the Lord, the Holy Spirit will lead us, and he filled with us Holy Spirit, and he will take care of us everything. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Just we'll pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. The Holy Spirit comes upon us. God, we will be set free from all the fear, all the darkness, all the evil power, and all the sorrow. Everything, we will get the deliverance, Master. My dear brothers and sisters, everybody, whomever watching, everybody, the Lord is filling with the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit is descend upon you, that you are completely, today you will be set free from all the difficulties. The coronavirus cannot affect you anything. None of the disease can calm you, because the Holy Spirit will escort you, and he will make a shield for you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen.